Welcome to the Mickey Mouse Club.
It's Thursday party day, and today we're blasting off with an outer space party.
On today's What I Want to Be, we meet an expert who trains animals we see on movies and in TV shows.
And right now, I've got some good news and bad news. The good news, we've all got backstage passes to the party in Iowa. The bad news is that the OKs are the opening act.
Sorry, guys. That opening act was a joke.
We're okay.
Matt.
Who booked him anyway?
How you doing, kids? Big Slate here.
Look, Mr. Swan.
It's Slate.
Whatever. First, that opening act. Then you put us in a flea bag motel. And what is this junk in the dressing room? Olive loaf roll-ups?
Hey, what's your point?
And where'd you get that stage crew?
The wonderful world of sound. Woofers, tweeters, meters, wires! My assistant, Bird!
I'm so sorry. Professor, I seem to have a slight mishap with the audio wires. I'm sorry.
No problem. This is science! Look! Notice! Dial! Soft? Loud? Louder?
Are you guys the party or the party poopers? Lighten up! Wait till you see who I've got backstage ready to meet you guys.
A mega,
major, superstar, and a very dear, very personal friend of mine.
Yeah. Oh.
Binky Burns.
Being a lobster?
We got a lobster.
Yeah!
You got a lobster.
You know, Binky, I'm your biggest fan. I'd love to play a part in your next movie.
Well, only if I can sing on your next album! That's why!
Baby, baby, baby!
That's why I got to see you, Hampton! That's why! That's why I got to see you!
Time to go on stage, party!
Baby, baby, baby!
I get so late!
Look at that time.
That's right!
Baby, baby, baby.
That's right!
Careful, gotta go.
Don't ever change.
Baby, baby, baby.
That's right!
Ladies and gentlemen, Slick Promotions in association with the Iowa Corn Husband Club is proud to present the party!
Thank you.
Tell them about it or say nothing.
Well, here's what some kids at Walt Disney World's Magic Kingdom said they would do.
Now that would be an embarrassing predicament.
I'll pay the waitress to tell her.
I would kindly tell him about it because I wouldn't want him to walk around feeling stupid or anything.
What would I do?
I kind of just lean over and go, maybe she'd catch on.
Well, at the end of the day, I'll say, honey, brush your teeth.
Come on, I'd get another date.
I would ignore it because I would just be happy to have the date.
I tried some psychology, like pick my teeth, wipe my teeth, and if he didn't do the same, I just wouldn't look at his mouth anymore.
I would get some stuck in my teeth, too, so at least we can match. I'd be a gentleman, and I'd get her a toothpick and politely suggest that she use it.
And now, Dude Talk with your host, Guy Dude.
Hey, dudes.
Hey, dudes.
Dudes, we are some lucky dudes today. With us is one cool dude. Let's give a Dude Talk welcome to Big Dude.
Yeah.
Hey, dude, so what's happening?
Dudacity, dude.
Really, dude? Like, how, dude?
Well, dude, it's just like, you know, dudical.
Gnarly, dude.
Some dude, huh?
Oh, dude!
No, dude, really.
Thanks, dude!
No, dude, thank you!
Well, dudes and dudettes, that's all the time we've got. Catch you later, dude!
That's so cool.
Oh, yeah.
Radical shame!
Like, totally rad!
Yeah,
and now, Radical Talk with your host, Guy Rad.
No, I don't think so.
Animals are specially trained for all sorts of purposes.
Yeah, some are used to help the handicapped, while others are taught how to do cool tricks for movies and TV shows.
On today's What I Want to Be, 16-year-old Jay Garofalo from Glendale, California, found out what it takes to be a Hollywood animal trainer.
So we sent Jay to spend a day with one of the top trainers in the business, Animal Actors of Hollywood. Watch.
Hi, how you doing? My name's Jay.
Hey, Jay, I'm Marc.
16-year-old Jay Garofalo loves animals and would someday like to train them. So today, Jay's being shown how it's done by veteran animal trainer Marc Harding.
I think being an animal trainer would be exciting because I have a great love for animals, and the animal trainers themselves also do.
Go! Come on, guys!
Marc works at Animal Actors of Hollywood, a place where the animals are trained for film and television. These lemurs are very shy, so by getting close to humans during this feeding session, they're learning to become more friendly as well as mastering a new trick.
Now what I want you to do with this one is, every time they're eating, just tap this.
Just tap it?
Just a little bit, right. We're getting them to come to the sound of the buzzer for food.
Marc says that lemurs are exciting animals to train, but training sea lions is tops.
The line up under the ball here, hold it. Seat. Seat. Hold it. Hold it.
Hop.
Good. All right, Sam, applause. Applause.
Jay found out right away that although these animals are being trained for the movies, it wasn't all glamorous. It's a lot of hard work caring for and feeding these animals.
You never think about the cleaning and stuff when you're involving the animal, but it's a lot of work, and it's something that has to be done, and not once a week, every day. So that's a lot of work in itself.
After cleaning the animals, Jay had a few minutes to talk to Marc about what it takes to become an animal trainer.
What kind of training did you need to become an animal trainer?
Well, everybody goes about it a different way. It's not one of those careers that, you know, is real specific. There are a few schools that offer programs, colleges that offer accredited programs in animal training. Most people really get their experience by coming to work for an animal training company.
Can your job be dangerous?
Yeah, we work with a lot of large, exotic, wild animals, and they're never fully, you know, domesticated. They're always still a little bit wild. And so, yeah, it can be.
Next, Jay tried his luck with the elephants. Serving food to this Dumbo was a real humdinger.
There's the bell.
Does that mean lunch is ready?
In a manner of speaking. Hey, why don't you go set this on the table?
Okay. My name is Jay. I'll be your waiter for the day. I was kind of nervous because as I went up, you know, I thought it was lunch, and actually it was the elephant's lunch. And I was waiting on him, and he'd ring the bell when he wanted something. He kept on taking the cookies. And, I mean, how do you know if your hand's not going to get swallowed up in his mouth as well?
So for now, Marc is hard at work training these animals for future movie roles, and as Jay found out, to be a good trainer, all you need to give is a little tender, loving care.
In order to be a great animal trainer, you have to have a lot of patience, and you have to show the animal that you really do care, and the animal will always love you for that. There are definitely some pluses and minuses to that job.
Yeah. The animals were great, but I don't know about having to clean up after them.
I guess it's just part of the job.
If there's something you want to be or see, write to us at the Mickey Mouse Club, Disney MGM Studios, P.O. Box 10200, Lake Buena Vista, Florida, 32830. And don't forget to include your name, address, and telephone number.
We'll be right back with today's party right after this.
Are you watching that trash again?
Oh, Ma!
Why can't this family ever get out and do something cultural for a change?
Hey, I know. Let's go visit the Doodleheim Museum of Doodle Art.
Oh, great.
Yes, the Doodleheim Museum, exhibiting exquisite works by young artists who absentmindedly scribbled on stuff. These artists work in a variety of media, such as canvas, plaster, and loose leaf. In our portrait gallery, see how one subject, 8th grade math teacher Miss Lavore, is treated by different creative minds. And you'll enjoy a self-guided walking tour of the Doodleheim. Just pick up one of our informative brochures and enjoy the show. But the Doodleheim Museum is not only entertaining, it's educational. In our studio program, students learn the art of doodling from professionals. The Doodleheim has special events, too. This month, we're proud to present the world-renowned Have a Nice Day exhibit, where you'll meet the artist himself, Mr. Stu Smiley. So come on down to Midvale's leading cultural attraction, the Doodleheim Museum of Doodle Art, and receive this handsome souvenir of your visit, suitable for framing.
The Doodleheim Museum is conveniently located just off I-4, right next to the Museum of Edible Art and the Museum of Refrigerator Art.
Hang on to your knives and forks. It's time once again to explore the strange world of culinary concoctions with Bizarre But Delicious.
Today's recipes involve the all-American hot dog, but I guarantee you haven't tasted one of these at a ball game.
Our first recipe comes from Catherine Matheson of Belmore, New York, who calls her creation the Dazzling Dog.
Dazzling Dog. Okay, I gotta see this one. What is this?
Okay, Marc, I need your help. Will you please fish me out a hot dog?
Sure.
Mmm. So beautifully served, Marc.
Well, thank you very much.
I'm going to roll it in there.
All right. Okay, as you can see, there is a slit.
Mm-hmm.
Catherine suggests boiling this for 10 minutes. Then you slit the hot dog. Then you pack as many mixed vegetables as you can.
Mixed vegetables?
The hot dog.
Yeah. And now, so is this vaguely healthy?
I don't know. It just smells good.
It does smell good. But you know, this would go perfectly with party pickles. The perfect compliment to anything, right?
Great idea, Fred. I mean, as they say, there's
a party in every pickle. And you know it. And it's got to be good, right? So what else do we do?
I want you to mix 1 tablespoon of honey and 1 tablespoon of mustard together.
Ooh. Okay, all right. Mustard? All right.
Yes, and...
Now, why am I doing this?
Okay, well...
Is this going to explode or anything?
You'll see. Just mix them together there.
Yeah. Got to cheer your child here.
Okay, that should be good enough.
All right, now what
do
we do?
Pour that over the whole hot dog.
Yeah? All right.
Pour that. Pour it.
That looks so good. Actually, that doesn't taste so bad, but that may be a problem. Let's come back to that. Let's see.
Wait a second.
Oh, you got more? There is more? How could it be more?
The crowning touch.
What's that?
Cinnamon. Over the whole pie.
Stand back, friend. Oh, this thing's going to go.
Okay, now that is the doll.
That's the dazzling dog. Okay, what have you got over here?
I have the dessert. Monty Gentry of Orlando, Florida sent us this recipe for the banana split on a dog. First thing you need is one hot dog, chilled,
chilled.
And then you take half a scoop of vanilla ice cream, half a scoop of chocolate ice cream.
I think the object here is to cover up the dog underneath.
And half a scoop of
strawberry ice cream. Who sent this? Monty Gentry of Orlando? She is twisted.
Really. Now you need some chocolate syrup.
Okay.
That is sick.
Ooh, you like chocolate syrup, don't you?
And she suggests 1 1/2 handful of peanuts.
Ooh. This thing is moving. Do you see it? Okay.
Now you need one banana sliced in half. Mm-hmm. And you put one in there.
That's the banana split part of it, I guess.
Exactly. Yeah. Uh-huh. And one in there. And top it all off. Whipped cream.
Oh!
You're dangerous with that!
Sorry, Fred.
I'll get you, my little stick.
Okay, so is that it? Is that all for that?
That's it.
I think what we should do is have you take... No, I need... Let's see the audience. How about you two over here? How about you with a bow in your head right there? Who else? We have... Yeah, you in the black shirt right there. Come on. Come have a seat. Tell me your name.
Michelle.
Yeah, and what's your name?
Justin.
Justin, come on, bring your concoctions over here. Justin and Michelle, now why would you volunteer for this?
Just to be crazy.
Just to be crazy? Well, you are if you eat this thing. Why would you? Do you eat wild things like this?
No, I don't think so.
No? You ready to try it?
I guess.
Good. Well, let's see. Let's see how they do. All
right. The dazzling dog.
Dazzling dog. Let's have a drum roll. Oh, he went for it. It's going to take a while before you can get that one down. Okay, let's see. He's coming up for air. What do you think?
Gross.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. One word sort of sums it up. Okay, you ready for this one? I think yours is actually a little more difficult.
You ready for the banana split on a dog? Now, you have to just pick it up and just jam it right in your mouth.
You got to go for the dog.
Just get it open.
All right, Michelle. Let's have another drum roll. It's going to take a while to pick this one up. What do you think?
Very disgusting.
That's even worse than gross, right? On the scale of grossosity? Well, I think you have it for bizarre but delicious. That's why they call that. Thank you very much for trying it. You are adventurous eaters, and you both get Mickey Mouse Club t-shirts for helping us out. And you know what? You can each get to take these home with you. So aren't you lucky? Thanks a lot. Thank you.
Well, that's all we have for Bizarre But Delicious today. But if you have a recipe, please send it to Bizarre But Delicious, Mickey Mouse Club, Disney MGM Studios, P.O. Box 10200, Lake Buena Vista, Florida, 32830. And if we read your recipe on the show, you'll get one of our Mickey Mouse Club t-shirts.
Captain's Log, Stardate Thursday. The Endless Prize is proceeding into a previously unexplored quadrant of the galaxy. What will we find?
Captain, my sensors are picking up something quite unusual.
Yes, Beta?
We appear to be moving into a region inhabited by multicolored paper particles, hovering inflated bladders and conical headpieces.
Put them on screen, Beta. Computer, analyze.
Spectrographic analysis concluded.
Results?
It's Thursday, party day, and we're having a space party.
Captain, my sensors are detecting two brief comedy sketches and a musical number. One can only describe them as entertaining. Shall I beam them up?
Make it so.
And now, here's everyone's favorite astronomer, Chuck Horsheimer, Star Looker-Adder.
Greetings, fellow Star Looker-Adders. Tonight, the heavens are having a birthday party, and you're all invited.
Alpha Centauri. Our nearest star neighbor is 4 billion years old tonight, but he doesn't look a day over 3 million. So bring a cake. We'll have fun, fun and cake, but don't tell the Big Dipper. He can't come. He takes up too much room. Okay, at 8:02, tear yourself away from that sitcom rerun, go outside, and look west, and you'll see Mars. Look south, and you'll see your feet. Look straight ahead, and you'll see me on TV. Hi. If you're at the South Pole, look northeast, and you'll see Aquarius. Wait. Hi, Aquarius! Now, I've always wondered how anyone saw a man with a jug of water in there. So if you're like me, and I hope you are, you might like to make up your own constellations, like Mary the Paperboy, or Eunice the Night Nurse, or me, Jock Horsheimer, Star Looker Adder. If you're at the North Pole, look southeast, and you'll see Cancer the Crab. Personally, I don't like shellfish, never did give me tummy rumbles, so I see a big bag of potato chips, or a hot fudge sundae, or a hot pepperoni pizza. Hey, how about a hot fudge pepperoni pizza? Ooh, I'm getting hungry. Remember, keep looking up.
You've been watching Chuck Horsheimer, Star Looker Adder.
Hey, kids. Looking for fun, excitement, adventure?
Yeah.
Want to broaden your horizons?
You bet.
Why not go to Space Camp?
Space Camp?
All right. There is a lot of space.
Yeah. Guys? Hello?
Is anybody there?
Space Camp, not affiliated with NASA, Cape Canaveral, or the space program.
Are we having fun yet?
Looking for still isn't found round and round.
real soon.
J-E-Y.
Why? Because we like you.
Reebok is proud to be the exclusive supplier of athletic footwear to the Mickey Mouse Club.
Come on and move, the minute move. MMC is always in the groove.
Yeah, I will.
Get it? Is that
word?
MMC. We'll rock the house. MMC. Rock the house. Rock it. Through the years, we'll all be friends wherever we may be.
Wonderful.
Plus, much more in the all-new Mickey Mouse Club tomorrow.